Okay, so welcome to PJ Con. PJ
Take
Con
two.
2021, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, goodness gracious. All right. Yeah. All right. Sorry about that. So, welcome to PJ Con 2021. For those of you just joining in, because nothing happened for the past few minutes, definitely not. Definitely not
Nope.
a silent mu movie or anything. This is Zanne Nilsson, a personal friend of mine and writer, but more importantly, ukulele shredder. With a chat also wanted to point out that you have an absolutely killer set of jams there.
The Kiku.
Yeah.
Yes, you can thank my wife Emma for not giving me permission to, not that she denied me permission, but I just borrowed it. We borrow each other's clothes all the time. You know, that's the benefit of both having the same fashion style. So, but yeah, this is my wife's dream cat, Kigu. You can see one of my favorite things about it has heterochromia. So should I just get on with the introduction then,
Yeah,
once again?
do your thing.
All right. Okay then. This is good. It'll be easier for me to run through it again this time. Hi everybody. I'm Zanne Nilsson. I'm one third currently of the band Thirdlife Crisis. We're named for the minor mental breakdown I had back in May when Jack Terrycloth, the lead singer of my favorite band, the World Inferno French Society, suddenly and unexpectedly died. Shortly after that, I had a, well, the most dangerous thought that an MB with a ukulele can have, which is nobody can stop me from writing a musical about anything I want. So, with that in mind, the next two songs are from the concept album we're currently working on. Working title is Sad Cats on a Space Train. It is loosely inspired by the Kenji Miyazawa book and the director's name escapes me, but 1985 anime movie, Night on the Galactic Railroad, which is about two friends riding on a magical space train to the stars.
All right.
First song is called River of Sky. It's about when the narrator first shows up on the train. They see their best friend there and they're like, oh, hey. So let's get started.
So Zan, from this point on, I am leaving the show up to you, so just let me know when you want me to come back. It's your stage.
Okay, I'll do my best.
Have
All righty.
fun.
Okay. All righty, let's go. Let me pull up the cheat sheet real quick. I know this song, but I just want to have something nearby in case I screw up. All right, let's go. You and me and the open sky and the rumbling beneath the floor. Didn't think we'd ever get the time to see the universal shore. How did we get here? I don't give a damn. You take these chances when you can. When the train comes by, don't ask why. You get on together, you go on forever. Just jump.
the street. Joy shines on with the stars. River sky, this world of dreams. And red light stars all burning bright. River of all the sky. We'll shine out of the flowing night. Earth endlessly passing by. We cannot be washed away like lanterns in the stream. Joy shines on with the stars, this river of sky, this world of dreams. Joy shines on with the stars and this river of sky, this world of dreams.
All right. Not my best performance, but like I always say, the point of playing the ukulele is not to do it perfectly, it's to have fun with it. So, check my cheat sheet. All right. The next song, it's called The Plasticine Coast. It's from a little later in the journey. The two characters, they stop off. There's like a little stopover, and they're like, oh, let's get off the train and explore. And they come across a professor from the distant future who's excavating the ruins of Earth. It's a cheerful song about how humanity destroyed itself. Let's go.
Of plasticine, we excavate the past. We found the styrofoam stratum of humanity at last. The species once built monuments to heroes, gods, and kings, but killed them all to free up time for just consuming things. And the only thing that lasted was the world they threw away. The trash and devastation's all that's left of them today. They bought their immortality and planet had to pay. But the only thing that lasted was the world they threw away. If you look closely at the sand, each grain's a sparkling gem. But to see the fire that burns inside, you must sift the trash from them. They're mixed with microplastics that once swept out to sea. Wish to wash ashore today, that's a human's legacy. And the only thing that lasted was the world they threw away. The trash and devastation's all that's left of them today. They bought their immortality and the planet had to pay. But the only thing that lasted was the world they threw away. Wasted planet saw the shows and they were even there. They saw their future in the stars but destroyed themselves instead, choking on the mess they made until they all were dead. The only thing that lasted was the world they threw away. Their trash and devastation's all that's left of them today. They bought their immortality and the planet had to pay. But the only thing that lasted was the world.
Time. Oh, we are good on time. So if anybody in chat has like a question or comment, or I would say a request, but I don't actually know a lot of songs. I mean, I know songs, but like probably not ones that there's a lot of Venn diagram overlap with y'all. But if nobody has any random questions, I can just scoot on to my next one. Let me take a look. Let's see, I know there's gonna be a delay. Let's see. All right. Okay, you. Rock on. Should have water though, because hydration is important. Alrighty. So this next one is not my own song, but it does have a bit of a story to it. It's called MTA. So for those of you unfamiliar with this one, which is probably most of you, it's an old campaign song for Walter O'Brien, who ran to be mayor of Boston in the late 40s. And sorry, I just saw Pat's comment in the chat, which later became like a folk classic kind of thing, oddly. At the time, like it's pretty much the only campaign song of his that kind of survived. And you'll see why, it's a fun song. At the time, its main impact, he didn't win the race, but he did get fined money for like violating a sound ordinance by playing his songs really loudly, which is punk as hell, honestly. And it's about a guy who gets trapped on the Boston subway system because he can't afford the increased exit fare. The song is still so widely remembered that the subway's fare cards now are named for the main character. On a personal level, this is one of the first songs I learned on the ukulele, and the reason why is because I have fond memories of it, because it was one of the songs my dad would sing to calm me down when I cried as a little kid. So it's like permanently burned into my brain. But in any case, it's a fun song. And I hope y'all like it. All right. Sorry, I keep getting distracted by the chat. All right, let's go. Well, let me tell you folks a story about a man named Charlie on that tragic and fateful day. He put 10 cents in his pocket, kissed his wife and family, went to ride on the MTA. But did he ever return? No, he never returned, and his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever near the streets of Boston, he's the man who never returned. Charlie Hannon in his dime at the Kendall Square station, and he changed for Jamaica Plain. When he got there, the conductor told him one more nickel, Charlie couldn't get off of that train. And did he ever return? No, he never returned, and his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever near the streets of Boston, he's the man never returned. Now all night long, Charlie cries through the stations, crying, what will become of me? How can I afford to see my sister in Chelsea or my brother in Roxbury? And did he ever return? No, he never returned, and his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever neath the streets of Boston, he's the man who never returned. Charlie's wife goes down to the Scully Square station every day at 2:15, and through the open window she hands Charlie a sandwich as the train goes a rumbling through. And did he ever return? No, he never returned, and his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever in the streets of Boston, he's the man who never returned. Now you citizens of Boston, don't you think it's a scandal how the people have to pay and pay? Fight the fare increase, vote for Walter O'Brien, get poor Charlie on the MTA. Or else he'll never return, no, he'll never return, and his fate will be unlearned. He may ride forever in the streets of Boston, he's the man who never returned. He's the man who never returned. He's the man who never returned. Alrighty. Oof. I tend to be better at that one because I play it all the damn time, as any of my friends who've known me for a fair amount of time have seen me play ukulele will tell you. Let me see what's going on in chat. Yay, y'all like the song. Alrighty, where are we on time? Okay, we got some time. Alright, sorry, I had some tea too. And I guess I have accidental product placed with my mugs. This is a local music shop in my hometown. It's where I got this uke, actually, and it's also where, like, I got my school instruments and shit growing up, so, like, my violin, I got there, they just supply, like, the town with music. So, and the other one, obviously, is Rehoboth being super gay, as it does. I love Rehoboth Beach. Anyway, getting off topic. Next one is a semi-cover, and I say semi because I wrote new lyrics to a song you probably know and may not like because it's notorious for being a little annoying, but I'm hoping the new lyrics will be good. Oh wait, how do you spell the shortened version of ukulele? So usually it's UKE. Some people do UKU because the way that the word is spelled in, like, the traditional Hawaiian language is UKU, well, the translated version, you know what I mean, would be UKULELE. And there's a lot of contention in the ukulele community about pronunciation and abbreviation because, like, you know, is it, it comes down to a lot of, like, is it what most people say or is it how it's actually supposed to be? So I prefer the UKU thing, but I do abbreviate it as UKE because that's how people know it. I don't know. Anyway, gotten off topic. Where are my notes? Oh, I'm so prepared. Yuki. Aw. Okay. So the next one is called You're an MB After All. And as much as I would love to make a demo of it sometime, I never can, and you'll see why. You can feel male sometimes and female too. You can feel that neither or both fit you. If you're not either or, then one thing is for sure, you're an MB. But yeah, for those of you playing along at home who sort of recognize the song, but not actually, it's A Small World from the Disney parks, which I think has become notorious for being annoying because, like, one, it's sung by a children's choir on the ride, and two, the ride is, like, 10 minutes long, so you hear it, like, 5 or 6 times in a row. So I think the melody is kind of cute, but it could use new lyrics, too, because the lyrics are very, very early 60s. Applause. Alrighty. Let's see if we have time. I think we have time for one more. If we have time for one more after that, I'd be happy to pull something out, but, I'll finish on probably the strongest one I have so far. So this is not associated with the concept album. It's just a random song I wrote recently about how much I fucking hate hustle culture, especially in creative fields. And by creative fields, I mostly mean writing, because that's the one that I run up against the most. And like every other article on Medium, the site where I mostly write, is like, here's how to write all the time and never do anything else and make money. And by make money, they mean like actually probably $20 a month on it. But they say like, here's how to make $50,000 a month. And I just don't give a shit. I want to write. So fuck it. Here's hustle harder, hustle cat. Side hustle yet, what the hell is wrong with you? You gotta exploit your interest, kid, and make money from what you do. Resting is a waste of time and hobbies are nonsense. Labors of love won't help you make a single goddamn cent. Boom, 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 hustle harder, hustle cat, lead your precious passion drive. Hustle harder, hustle cat, kiss your sweet free time goodbye. Hustle harder, hustle cat, and don't you dare ask why. Hustle harder, hustle cat, hustle until you die. You can't write stuff just for fun, you gotta go somewhere. Build your platform, build your base, so nobody will care. Gotta get engagement up, post content every day. Likes are all that matter, kid, not what you have to say. Boom, 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 hustle harder, hustle cat, lead your precious passion drive. Hustle harder, hustle cat, kiss your sweet free time goodbye. Hustle harder, hustle cat, and don't you dare ask why. Hustle harder, hustle cat, hustle until you die. Authorship ain't worth a thing without an author brand. Just another product here in hustle culture land. Yet you won't get anywhere if you don't listen to me. Buy my mentorship today. Who says advice is free? Boom, boom, boom. Hustle harder, hustle cat, your precious passion drive. Hustle harder, hustle cat, kiss your sweet free time goodbye. Hustle harder, hustle cat, and don't you dare ask why. Hustle harder, hustle cat, hustle until you take a kid. Okay, wrap it up, kid, wrap it up. Hustle harder, hustle cat, lead your precious passion drive. Hustle harder, hustle cat, kiss your sweet free time goodbye. Hustle harder, hustle cat, and don't you dare ask why. Hustle harder, hustle cat, hustle until you hustle until you hustle until you die.
All right. I am not as great performing yet, but I think the song is solid, so. Alrighty, let's see what's going on in chat. I'm glad you liked it, Pat. Oh my god. Thank you all so much. Oh my god, more, oh god. I don't have time for more, Pat. here, you can encore, okay.
I'll leave it up to chat. Do you want an ABBA cover or a semi-cover of an 80s song? Or do you want the... No, I haven't performed that other one, practiced that other one. So do you want a semi-cover or a cover? Leave it up to chat. Boom, now on your phones. Which 80s song? Do I spoil it or not? No, it's Video Killed the Radio Star, but with new lyrics. Yes, okay. Here, I've got to pull up. Oh shit, I'm gonna. Okay. I don't think I have it printed, so I'm gonna have to pull up the lyrics on my screen. I hope you all will bear with me just a moment. Sorry. I'm not as prepared as I thought I'd be. Once I have the lyrics up, I will give you a little background. Come on, Google. Signs. Oh god, this is actually going to be kind of hard to sing because I'm not good at doing high parts, at least not jumping from low parts to high parts, but let's give it a try. Thank you for indulging our clamoring. Okay, well, I mean, somebody wants to actually hear me perform instead of being like, yeah, okay, cool. So, hell yeah, I'm going to indulge. All right, so this one is called Vitaphone Killed the Vaudeville Star. It's a semi-cover with rewritten lyrics about the decline of vaudeville after Hollywood started poaching the stars for sound films. It's named for the Vitaphone varieties, which were short sound films that frequently used popular vaudeville performers and often killed their live careers in the process by ruining the novelty of an act that could have lasted like months or years in live performances. Like, you know, you go to see somebody and it's like, oh, they're bouncing on a unicycle while like stacking cats on their head. I've already fucking seen that. I don't care. So it's, you'll see, it kind of tells a story, I guess, but no, not I guess, it does. It fucking does. I'm gonna stop putting myself down. All right, let's see how well I can do on this. I saw you on the circuit back in 25 at New York Palace where the vaudeville show thrived. You were the headliner who made us feel alive. Oh, and soon came invitations out to Hollywood with promises you'd be a movie star for good. They filmed your act and took away your livelihood. So how could that be? Say, can you tell me? Vitaphone killed the vaudeville star. Vitaphone killed the vaudeville star. Talkies came and stole your show. Now you appear with rejects in some no-name town, reduced from stardom to a disregarded clown who sees that there is nowhere left.
Too bad. Shit, that was amazing.
Thank you. Okay, let me check the chat one last time. All right. Aw, we're singing and dancing. So high. All right. Thank you all so much, and thank you again for having me.
Oh, it was my pleasure. Thank you very much for joining us. Chat, big round of applause for Zanne Nilsson. This was one of those things, Jasper and I were kind of talking about it, that like, we really appreciated all of our friends kind of coming together to do stuff for this con. But the thing that we weren't expecting is just how much fun it's been so far. Like, we were just like bopping around to by the way, if we don't post any of this to YouTube, at least let me clip the Hustle Cat song, because that was baller. Like, absolutely incredible.
Definitely. We'll talk about it later, but hell yeah.
That was just, oh my goodness. So thank you again for joining us. Chat and everybody for PJ Con up next. We have Gaming and Trash Talking with Mario Kart. You all get to watch Jasper kick my ass. And Zan, thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Y'all take care.
Bye.